Hey YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator course called Illustrator Essentials. You can check it out on bringyourownlaptop.com. If you want to follow along with this video, there's exercise files, okay? Those are free to download. You can go and download those and there'll be a link in the description, okay? So you can play along. One last thing is there's a cheat sheet as well. So there is a PDF you can download from bringyourownlaptop.com. Look for resources, okay? It's a free PDF. You can download it, print it up, stick it next to the computer while you're doing these videos. All right, enjoy the video. Bye now. Hi there, in this video, we're gonna look at the Shape Builder tool. I love this tool. It's absolutely my most favorite tool out of all of the tools in Illustrator. And we're gonna take this drawing that we did of the fox with simple shapes and ta-da, add some kind of shadows to it. Not so much exciting about the shadows, but more the technique that we use the Shape Builder tool to kind of be able to carve out extra colors within other shapes. I love it. Let's go and learn how to use it now. All right, to get started with the Shape Builder tool, let's start with a really simple file. Go to File, Open. There is a file in here called Shape Builder. Click Open. Now this file is not very exciting. All it is I'm on my black arrow. It's just a couple of circles on top of a rectangle. Okay, so what I'd like to do is I would like to say this circle to join this rectangle. So I'm gonna use my black arrow and select them all. And we're gonna go to the Shape Builder tool. It's this guy here. He is the absolute best thing that ever happened to Illustrator. Okay, and what it allows me to do is you can see by default, there's a little plus next to my cursor there. Okay, what I can do is watch this. I can hover above this, click, hold down my mouse and just drag a line. You see I drag it across all three of these kind of parts and they are fused now as one thing. And that is just awesome. No more Pathfinder and trying to join things. It's really easy. Simple shapes using the Shape Builder tool and they join. Another cool trick is that if I hold down the Option key on a Mac or the Alt key on a PC, you can see it changes from a plus to a minus. So what I can do now is I want to minus this and this. I'm holding down my mouse key, okay, and I can drag across those two bits to minus those bits off. Okay, so that is its main two uses, joining things and minusing things. It also has another little trick where I've got these two bits selected, right? And what I can do is I can pick a fill color, let's say this, and use it for not minusing or adding, but just coloring in bits. So I'm gonna click off in the background here and watch this. I can just click on that, okay? And it uses that as the fill color. Just really handy to go through, pick a color, click off, click in there, and it just fills shapes. Okay, I can go back to my black arrow, and now if I click off, it's actually just three separate shapes that are being colored in. Let's use it in a kind of a practical sense now. So let's close this guy. I don't want to save him because it wasn't that exciting. Okay, so before we go and create our own kind of like custom shapes with the Shape Builder tool, I'm going to show you how I use it mostly. So I want you to open up the fox that we made earlier. If you haven't done that tutorial, you can cheat, go to the exercise files and download one called Shape Builder 2. Open them up. So what I'd like to do is I want to kind of add some shadows to this, like you saw it at the beginning of this video. Okay, and so first thing we have to do is with the black arrow, let's just grab this background and just move it over to the side, just to make life a little easier. Let's go to the layers and turn off the view of the template. We'll move it back in later on. So what I'd like to do is I'm just gonna start with the head. Okay, I'm gonna grab the line tool. I'm gonna draw a line that goes from this ear and I'm gonna go all the way through his kind of face here just to show you how good the Shape Builder tool is. I'm gonna grab the black arrow and I'm gonna have this selected plus holding shift and grabbing this selected. So I've got the head and the line there, just those two, and go to properties. Okay, I'm gonna go to my Shape Builder tool and I wanna color it. So like we did earlier with the red and the blue, I'm gonna pick a fill color. I'm going to go to my swatches here. I'm gonna pick the orange. I'm gonna move to this like color mixer, pre-made swatches here, color mixer here. And I wanna make it a bit dark. Watch this, this K is black. Okay, you can see if I drag it up, it gets a bit dark. I'm gonna go to maybe 10%. Okay, you can be a bit more flexible with yours. And now just need to click anywhere out to close that box. Cool, now when I hover above, I click once and I've got this lovely dark, lovely, okay, it's fine. So yeah, cast the shadow here. Now, next thing I wanna do is grab my black arrow and just click off in the background. Okay, there are some bits left over. That thing there, if you've got some black hanging off the end here, you can just select it and hit delete, don't need it anymore. Next thing I wanna do is maybe cast a shadow underneath its chin, same thing, line tool, cast some sort of fake casting shadow thing, okay, black arrow, hold shift, so I've got both the line and this body selected. Go to, actually you can't go to fill yet, you've got to go to the shape builder tool. Okay, then go to fill, and then I'm gonna use that, you can see it's the last color that I used, and it's pre-mixed it. If it hasn't, you can go back to the swatches, click this one, go here, do 10%. Hopefully you can use the last mixed, save some time. Okay, and I'm just gonna hover above, maybe get a click out, hover above this, click once, and this is gonna run into our first problem with the shape builder tool. Okay, grab the selection tool, click off in the background. You can see this has ended up above everything, okay, which is fine, okay? All I need to do is, with it selected with a black arrow, click arrange and send to back. Now we've been using send to back. You might just need to send backwards. Backwards goes back one step. Okay, if I click backwards now, it's not gonna quite work. It's probably going behind, I don't know, this. And you can keep going backwards, and it's just one step at a time, backwards, backwards, and eventually you'll get there. Okay, I'm gonna go arrange send to complete back. Awesome. Now I'm gonna do a couple more shadows. You can follow along if you like. I'm gonna grab this, copy and paste it, make it bigger. I'm gonna use it like for a shadow for his bum. I'm gonna select both of these, holding shift, okay, with my black arrow, move to the shape builder tool, pick a fill color. Last used color, didn't work. Okay, I'm gonna go to here and pick 10%, click off, and then click that one. Back to my black arrow, click off in the background, grab him, don't need you anymore, buddy. I'm gonna do the same with the tail here, copy paste it, make it a bit bigger, use it to kind of make some sort of tail shadow. Select both of them, holding shift, go to my shape builder tool. You will get it after a time, like shape builder tool is one of the shortcuts I use loads. If I hover above the tool, can you see it says shift M? Okay, that's both for Mac and PC. If I hold down the shift key on my keyboard and type M, it jumps to the shape builder tool. And the black arrow is V. So very often I'm going V, shift M. You can see in my toolbar, I'm kind of jumping between the two by just clicking those keys. All right, fill, I'm gonna use this one, 10%, click off. And I'm gonna say, yep. Go back to my black arrow, which is the V key. Delete this one. I'm gonna create some sort of line here. Now I'm just mucking about. You can skip on if you like. Okay, select both of them. Shift M. Pick a darker color than I had before from my swatches. About that. Kind of looks like he's doing, casting a shadow from the moonlight. Okay, I'm gonna grab this one, drag it back in. Okay, snap it up. You'll notice that it's in the wrong kind of layer order. So what I'm gonna do is select them, arrange, and send to back. And that's kind of how I use the shape builder a lot. I kind of get the basics in with some shapes and then use other shapes and the shape builder tool to kind of construct some more sophisticated artwork. All right, so that's kind of updating an existing drawing. Let's go and make something cool in the next video, totally with the shape builder tool. It's pretty nice, and it's one of those styles that are trending at the moment. So let's go and look how to do that in the next video. Hi there, in this video, we're gonna make this swooshy looking fox thing using my favorite tool, the shape builder tool. Look at him, he's all made of little shapes and bits and pieces. Okay, let's put you back together, fox, and let's go learn how to make you in Adobe Illustrator. Okay, so let's start with a new document. File new, you can use US letter landscape or A4 landscape, it doesn't matter. Click on create, and we're gonna bring in the little drawing we're gonna copy from. Okay, so let's save this document, file save, and let's put it on our desktop in our Illustrator class files. Let's call this one Awake Fox. And let's click okay. Let's bring in the image we're gonna redraw. Okay, we're gonna go to file place. And we're gonna use in our exercise files, there's one called awakefox.jpg. And remember, like in a previous tutorial, we could just bring it in and put it on its own layer and lock it and turn the transparency down. You can do that all in one file swoop by just clicking this template as you bring it in. And remember, you, watch this, it's created two layers. One's a template layer and you can't touch it, okay? And they've dimmed it down so you can draw on it easily. And we're working on layer one. Let's go back to properties. Now, there is no real particular order to start this, but you might as well follow me. Okay, so let's start with, say, the polygon tool. And if we click once, we're gonna make sure it says three sides. We're not too worried about the radius at the moment. Just click okay. And what we can do is black arrow, holding shift, drag it out to the right size and rotate it around. Okay, we did rotation and scale in an earlier tutorial. Okay, I'm going to get it roughly in there. Now, you'll notice that it tries to snap to the edge of the page and like lots of those purple arrows. That's really handy. Sometimes it's just nice to get it close and use your arrow keys on your keyboard. Okay, just to kind of tap it around with the keyboard to get it kind of close. I'm happy with that. And what I'd like to do is have no fill and a black stroke. So I've got my black stroke. If you don't, click on stroke, click black, fill color. Let's go for no fill color. Now I'm not sure which part to start with. I'm gonna start with the ears here. So I'm gonna grab and hold down the polygon tool and grab the ellipse tool. And I'm gonna draw an ellipse. Just holding down shift, remember, gets a perfect circle. If I let go of shift, it can get a weird shape. It's up to you what you wanna do. I'm gonna start with perfect circles. Something like that, black arrow. Remember, I can't click the center because it has no fill. So I'm gonna click the edge and kind of drag it. And you can kind of see, I'm gonna use it maybe for that one, and it's a bit big. So I'm just resizing it until I get something close to that part. Using my keyboard to tap it around again. Cool, so that'll do. I'm going to copy it and paste it and then move it up. So I've got it kind of here as well. Okay, I think I used a slightly smaller one. There we go. Even smaller than that. I'm trying to match that circle in there. That will do. Cool, all right. So next thing I'd like to do is start using my Shape Builder tool. So I'm gonna select everything. Okay, so my black arrow, select everything on the page, and I'm gonna move to my Shape Builder tool. Now what I wanna do is, I don't want to add any of these guys, I want to subtract this chunk up here that I don't need. Now, who remembers what the shortcut is? That's right, it's Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC. Okay, hold it down, you see I get a minus, and I can drag across all of that. Click on him, you can see I can kind of minus those chunks off. I wanna leave that, because that's gonna be the kind of white of the nose. These guys though need, they're doing some weird stuff, so I'm gonna join them all. Remember, holding no keys down will add. Okay, I'm gonna add all that to it. I'm gonna minus that off, I'm gonna minus that off. And yeah, that's kind of the basics for it. All right, I'm gonna grab my black arrow. And what do I wanna do now is I want the other ear. So I'm just gonna copy it, paste it, so I've got another version. This guy here. I can't quite remember. I don't know. I'm going to rotate it around a little bit. Awesome. Cool. So I've got another set of ears back here. Maybe not so much rotation. Cool. Now with everything selected, again, let's grab the Shape Builder tool. And that bit's perfect. Now I just want to join these together. That bit there. Now the nose got all kind of disjointed with all these little bits. You might have to zoom in a little bit. Remember, Command Plus or Control Plus. And I'm gonna join all of that together so it's one unit. Now it starts looking a bit hard because you're like, what is the drawing underneath and which is mine? You might go to Layers and turn this on and off just to get a sense of what it is. So anything I'm really missing is the circle for the eye. So let's do that. Grab the Ellipse tool, drag this out. Why am I dragging it up here? No reason, I'm gonna drag it down here. Habit. Move it around, select all of this chunk, and I'm gonna grab this Shape Builder tool, and I'm gonna, what am I gonna do? I wanna add all of that together. That kind of worked. Cool. All right, on off on that bottom layer, it's looking good. Now we just need the neck. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit and grab an ellipse tool. Try and draw a circle big enough for that outside bit. Holding shift, that feels about right. All right, nope, that's way too big. Hold it down. Remember grabbing the edge, not the center of the circle. So I've got him, and there's one stripe, two stripes. So I'm gonna copy and paste him, and I'll use that one. Yeah, he's roughly the right size. Paste another one. Actually, I don't need to paste another one. There's only two there. Okay. Don't need that guy. Koei. All right, so I am now gonna select it all, grab my Shape Builder tool, and I'm gonna say, don't want you, don't want you. Actually, I do want you. There's the ellipse there. Why did I delete that one? I do need it. Okay, so there was a circle that I was missing. You probably saw it while you were doing it. I went, no. There it is there. We do need three circles. Now, one of the things is gonna happen here, if I zoom in, okay, and scroll up here, holding my space bar, you see it doesn't kind of line up here. To make the Shape Builder work kind of nicely, you need to overlap everything. So I'm zoomed in, it's just easier when you've zoomed in. Okay, now I'm gonna grab the edge and you'll just try and get it to snap in there. It's reasonably forgiving. It doesn't have to be absolutely scientifically perfect, but reasonably close, a couple of pixels. Now I'm gonna select it all. I'm gonna grab my Shape Builder tool and I'm gonna say, I don't want that. I don't want any of that. I don't want that. I don't need that. I'm going to come in here. What I might do now is turn off the template, because I kind of know those two I want, those two I want. If you're finding it a little bit tough, don't worry. It is a little bit tough trying to work out. You end up deleting the wrong bits. Like, there's a chunk through here. I'm going to add you guys together. Black arrow, select the background. Yeah, we're pretty close. Okay, there's some weird strokes going on that are different sizes. There's a thin one there and a thick one there. I'm going to select them all and say properties, and I'm going to give them all the same stroke width of this 0.25 points. Okay, just a really thin one to get us going. All right, that is looking good. If you find you've got like kind of junk in the nose, like there's a little trim bit, just zoom in, use your Shape Builder tool to try and tidy it up. You might even use a black arrow, just click bits and delete it. Okay, now what I want to do is go and color it. Now I'm going to put in a nice big gray background. I don't know why, everything looks better on a dark gray background. I'm just drawing a nice big rectangle. I'm going to fill it with our dark gray. Okay, and I'm going to have no stroke on it. I'm going to click arrange, send it to the back, and now I'm going to fill this with color. Okay, and there's a couple of ways of filling it. I can just click the edges, okay, and go and fill it, or I could use the Shape Builder technique like we did in the last video. It's up to you. And yeah, I'm going to go pick colors, foxy colors. Okay, I'm going to mix my own. I'm going to click on the mixer, okay, where I've got my object selected. I've clicked on fill, I've clicked on mixer, and I'm going to click down here to try and find a foxy color. Okay, that's going to be my kind of lead color. I'll pick this one, click on fill. I'm going to use the premix color and just make it a bit darker by grabbing the K and lifting it up a little bit. Cool. I'm going to use this kind of back of the head bit by doing the same sort of thing. Okay, I'm going to use that, but lighten it up. Okay, go even lighter. Cool. This bit here is going to be just, should be white, maybe I'm going to use just like an off-white, because it looks cool. Same with you, and off-white. All right, I'm going to select it all as well. Okay, now if I select all of it, okay, I'm going to end up with the background selected as well. And that's fine, because I want to go to stroke, and I want to say none of you's got a stroke. Thank you very much. And that is our cool little fox thing. All done with the Shape Builder tool. Get some nice kind of swooshes and swirls, and it's kind of flowy. Okay, those are words I'm just making up, but you get the idea, right? It's this kind of nice swooshy thing. So now it is time for the end and the time for the class project. So what I've done is I've done another sketch that you can use that I want you to go through and use the same techniques from the Fox, but we're going to use a new document, use file, place, and you're going to bring in this one called Swan. Yes, that's meant to be a swan. Okay, I drew it, kind of looked like a swan, kind of a chunky swan. You're allowed to, it doesn't have to be perfect like this. I guess what I want to see is a better swan, nice colors. Yeah, it's totally up to you. You can draw it perfectly if you like. Okay, but using the same tools as we did using the Shape Builder tool and the Fox, okay, I'd like you to go off and do the swan. And again, I'd like to see your projects. All right, that is it for this video. Let's get on to the next one. Actually, no, you're gonna get off and start doing your homework. Draw the swan, make him better. All right, see you in the next video though. Hi, what did you think of the video? If you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also leave me a comment, let me know what you liked about it. Also, this is kind of a short part of a longer course. Okay, if you wanna check that out, it's at bringyourownlaptop.com. This is the essentials course. Okay, there is also another course, there is an advanced course. Okay, for Illustrator, and also a UI web app design version of Illustrator course as well. Check all those out. Also, it's quite a visual course. I'd love to see what you've actually made. On Instagram, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop. Okay, check that out. Also, remember there's a cheat sheet you can download. Bring Your Own Laptop. It's free under resources. Check all that out, and yeah, I'll see you in another video. Bye now.